2 plus j omega. You can perform the partial fraction expansion. Say j omega is equal to minus 1. So this a is already there. 2 minus 1 is 1. So 1 by this. Like that, j omega is equal to minus 2. So you get a minus 1. Now you can take inverse Fourier transform. Take the inverse Fourier transform take the inverse Fourier transform of the above relation to obtain x of t as a into e raised power minus t u t minus e raised power minus 2 u t. This is x t. Now, let us come to the fact 3. Fact 3 is regarding Parseval's relation. So, using Parseval's relation, using Parseval's relation, we have minus infinity to infinity x of j omega mod square d omega. This is 2 pi minus infinity to infinity x of t mod square dt. Now, this is in from fact 3, this is given to be 2 pi. So, 2 pi equal to 2 pi integral minus infinity to infinity x t square dt. So, this 2 pi cancels and we get 1. So, what we get here is minus infinity to infinity x of t mod square dt is 1. Since x t is a real signal, then this becomes x t we have obtained like this a e raise power minus t u t minus e raise power minus 2 t u t whole square dt. Let make it whole square, of course, a has to be square. So, this becomes, because the presence of u t, this goes from 0 to infinity a square e raise power minus 2 t plus e raise power minus 4 t minus 2 e raise power minus t into e raise power minus 2 t 3 t dt. So, this becomes a square. This is given to be 1. So, a square, let us integrate e raise power minus 2 t, minus 2 t by minus 2, then e raise power minus 4 t, e raise power minus 4 t by minus 4, and let us integrate this e raise power minus 3 t, and then from 0 to infinity, this is given to be 1. Now, when t is infinity, all these limits are gone. So, at t equal to 0, we get this as a square 1 by 2 plus 1 by 4 plus this was already minus. So, minus and minus becomes plus. So, minus 2 by 3. This is given to be 1. If we simplify, we get a square. This is 12. 6 plus 3 minus 3. No, minus 8. equal to 1. So this becomes a square 1 by 12 equal to 1. So what we get is a square equal to 12. So a becomes plus minus root 2, root 12. Now signal x t is given to be a non-negative signal, non-negative. So we have to take the positive value of a, since signal x t is given to from fact 1, x t is real and non-negative. From fact 1, x t is known to be real and non-negative. We choose a as, so the required signal x t becomes root 12 e raise power minus t minus e raise power minus u t. This was required. Let us take another problem, 4.15. This says let x t be a signal with Fourier transform x j omega. Suppose we are given the following facts. Fact 1, x t is real. Fact 2, x t equal to 0 for t less than equal to 0. That means x t does not exist in negative time domain. Fact 3, 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity real of x j omega e raise power j omega t d omega, this is given to be mod t e raise power mod of t, determining a closed form expression for x t. Let's observe these three facts carefully. X t is real and x j omega is the Fourier transform of x t, and x t is 0 for t less than 0. This means inverse Fourier transform of real part of x j omega, and real part of x j omega will be equivalent to the even part of x t. The even part of x t, the Fourier transform of even part of x t will turn out to be real of x j omega. So let us use this relation as the starting point. And one more fact, we have been given xt as real. Since xt is real, since xt is real, the even part of xt can be obtained as xt plus x of minus t by 2. We are given that inverse Fourier transform inverse Fourier transform, that means IFT of real of x j omega is given to be mod t e raised power mod of t. Therefore, even of even part of xt is xt plus x of minus t by 2 equal to mod t e raised power mod t. Now, from fact 2, we have been given xt is 0. For t less than 0, we are also given that x t equal to 0 for t less than equal to 0. This implies that x of minus t is 0. So, hence this is 0, then x t becomes twice of mod t e raised power minus of mod t for t greater than equal to 0. So, this signal can be now written as x t, because this corresponds only to the positive part, 2 t e raised power minus t u of minus t, u of minus 2 to account for this. So, this is the closed form expression for signal x t. Let us take the problem number 4.13. Let x t be a signal with Fourier transform x t, its Fourier transform is given to be x j omega, which is, its Fourier transform is defined as x j omega, which is stated as delta omega plus delta omega minus 5 plus delta omega minus 5, and let there be a system whose impulse response S t is u of t minus u of minus t, t minus 2. Then first part is x t periodic. Let's do part by part. Is x t periodic? That means I have to find out the signal corresponding to x t. We know x t can be obtained from the relation this 1 by 2 pi minus infinity to infinity x of j omega e raise power j omega t d omega. From this relation you can find x t. So, x t will be 1 by 2 pi say minus infinity to infinity, let us substitute for x j omega. This is delta omega plus delta omega minus 5 plus delta omega minus 5 e raise power j omega t d omega. Now, the first integral delta omega e j omega, let us use the shift property of delta function. So, this simply becomes 1. So, 1 by 2 pi, 1 by 2 pi. Now, next integral is 1 by 2 pi, let us use the shift property of this. When omega I becomes pi, then this becomes e raise power j pi t. Now, third integral, when omega becomes 5, then from shift property it becomes e raise power j 5 t 1 by 2 pi. Now, signal x t we have obtained. Signal x t comprises of a constant part summed up with two complex exponential. Now, let us try to find out what is the period of this. So, if I replace this period, let us call this period as t 1 and this period as t 2. Then the period t 1 of this can be obtained from phi t 1 equal to 2 pi. So, this cancels. So, t 1 becomes 2. Now, the period of this part, this becomes 5 t 5 t 2 becomes 2 pi. So, t 2 becomes 2 pi by 5. Now, the signal x t will be periodic provided t 1 by t 2 becomes a rational fraction. Now, let us see what t 1 by 2 t in this case is. T 1 is 2 divided by 2 pi by 5. So, this becomes 5 pi by 5 divided by pi. The ratio of t 1 by t 2 is not a rational number. The ratio of t 1 by 2 t is not a rational fraction, is not rational fraction. So, x t is not a periodic signal. So, x t is not a periodic signal. Now, the next part part B says is part B says is XT convolution with ST periodic. So that means we have to convolve signal XT with ST. And the convolution of let yt be xt convolution st. So now let's take Fourier transform both sides. If we take Fourier transform of both the sides. If we take Fourier transform both sides, we will get y j omega as x j omega into h j omega. So y j omega we obtained as x j omega Now H j omega we can obtain from ST as e raised power minus j omega sin omega by omega. The function H j omega equal to 0 when omega is k pi, where k is a non-zero integer. So y j omega becomes x j omega